Hi, welcome to my channel. I will be showing you how to do a vegetation grow effect using Blender. And at the end, it will look like something like this. To start, I have with me here two things. An animation and a character for Mixamo in which we will adjust. And I have some plants models I got from the add-on Blender kit. It's really easy to use, just scroll through, pick the one you like, and watch it download. But make sure to scroll down and press break the scene. Now's the fun part. Add a plane as our ground and scale it up. Add the sphere that we are going to shape as a rock. You can use a sculpting brush with a cloud texture to add some more depth into it. Make sure the hand placements are believable. Once you are done, subdivide the sphere and move to the ground. Subdivide that and move a few vertices up and down using proportional editing. Now we can start fixing the animation to fit our scene. Switch to the animation tab, open the action editor that you can find in the dope sheet, and open a nonlinear animation. Rename the animation to something you like, and then push it down. That will turn all the keyframes to something that can be viewed as a layer that you can add on top of. This is how we are going to adjust it and make the character interact with our rock. There are so many videos out there that will show you how to animate if you're interested, but for this video I'm going to speed through the process. This is the end result of all the adjusting. It's not perfect, but it's good enough. Once you're done, go ahead and add a sphere and position it next to the character's head, far away from the rock, because this is going to control the weight paint for the particle system. Change the display to wire so you can see better. And set a keyframe and animate your sphere to grow as soon as the character's hand touches the rock. Select the rock, enable the physics for the dynamic paint, and set it as a canvas. Change the surface type from paint to weight. Do the same for the sphere, but make it a brush. Change the paint source to mesh volume plus proximity, and lower down the distance to something like 0.4. If we switch to weight paint mode, we can't see anything. That's because we need to select the rock, scroll down to the output and add the vertex group. And now, we can see that the sphere is painting the weight on the rock. We are going to use this vertex group to control the particle system. Bake the weight paint so it doesn't calculate every time you press play. Add the particle system, change it to hair, add children to it, and scroll through the timeline to watch the hair grow. Down at the roughness tab, play around with the settings to make the hair strands look messy and random, because nature is usually messy. Change the render from path to collection and pick the collection that's holding your plants. Scale them up and randomize the scale. You can also do what I did by individually duplicating some plants and changing their scale. I wanted to add more grass than flowers and that's what I did. You can change the display amount to see how it might look once rendered. And for me, I wanted more, so I later on changed the render amount to 250. Here I'm changing the rotation of the plant so that it looks a lot better than it was before. And I also decided to add a few more grass just so it looks better, I guess. And then I moved on to texturing. The easier way to do this is to select a bunch of edges on the bottom and then set them as a seam and unwrap the thing. I got the rack texture from the Blender kit. I did the same thing for the ground. I changed the textures later, but I wanted to keep this part in so you can see that you can control the textures by using the RGB curves and match it with the other textures you get. And a very important thing to add is a force field physics to the animated sphere to add more life to the plants as if they are actually growing and being pulled out. You can also add a subtle wind if you want. go to the render view, make sure that the sphere is disabled from being rendered by clicking the display and the camera icon. Just like that, the scene is ready to get rendered. Thank you so much for watching. Leave a comment and let me know what you think.
And here's the final render. 3G.